And the second or the third comment comes from American Liberty. Every mic seems to have a place in the world of audio creation, some solely to build the experimental knowledge of learning the meaning of bad audio, while others aid in facilitating the creation of audio works of art. Although I'm not one to dissuade individuals from seeking perfection, I do think items of overkill can be a distraction of the pursuit of content, content, content. So, American Liberty, you just keep coming back with these awesome comments and good insights. So I agree with you absolutely. The main focus of any content creator should be content, content, content. That's why you are called a content creator, not an audio creator. You are a content creator because that should be the main focus of what you're doing. So I assume the reason or what instigated this comment was people were really unhappy with the Sennheiser microphone sound last week. So let me go ahead and explain why I switch microphones about every month. It's not because I'm in the pursuit of perfect audio. Everybody knows I love the Shure SM7B and would be perfectly happy using that for the rest of my podcasting career. I would be 100% okay with that. The reason I switch microphones every month is because it allows me time to really get a good feel for the higher end microphones. And I think the $900 microphones, the $1,000 microphones, the $600 microphones, they deserve a little bit more time to understand the intricacies of them and really get a good feel for them, how they handle processing, how they work in different environments, all sorts of testing like that. So additionally, if I do use a $900 microphone 5, 6, 10 times, I feel a little bit better about buying it because, as you know, I do buy the majority of microphones that I review, almost all of them. So when I spend $900 on a microphone, I would like to get as much use out of it as possible. So it's about understanding the microphone a lot better, but also making me feel a little bit worse about spending so much money on a microphone that if I didn't use it for the podcast, I would make 1, 2, or maybe 3 videos about it. And that would feel very bad. Still, using it for 9 videos, 10 videos, not a good way to spend your money. That's $90 a video. So it's still not much better, but it does make me feel a little bit better. So that's why I constantly am testing these higher-end microphones on the podcast. It's not because I'm looking for better audio. I love the audio I have with the SM7B. It's just a good way to really test out the microphone for podcasting, actually using it in a podcast. That's why I do it.